the nutritional profile? Can this lady absorb saturated fats or not? So maybe she can have ghee, but her saturated fat will come back, she cannot have. So each person is different. Okay, next slide. So what are the two components that make you an athlete? You have to understand this. Once you understand this, you've understood how to eat correctly. What are the two components that make you an athlete?
Willpower.
No, I'm talking about the physical aspect. Willpower is the what the brain is giving. But what are the two physical things that make you an athlete? Next slide. Muscle gives you speed. Muscle gives you power. Muscle gives you strength. Muscle gives you flexibility. Muscle gives you all of these things. The brain controls all of this. These are two components that you have to understand as cricketers. That if you control the fuel to the brain and the fuel to the muscle, it is a smoothly running engine for the next 10 years. The moment you give brain lack of nutrition, that could be, I went to play a shot, I thought I played it correctly, I told my brain to tell my muscle to play this, but my muscle was 1/10 of a microsecond slower and the bat touched the ball a micromillisecond later and it edged to first leg. So this is how performance gets affected when the brain is not fed. When the muscle is not fed, I want to take that square cut or I want to hold the ball at 125 kilometers an hour, but I want to manage the speed. My brain is telling my muscle says, boss, get lost, you didn't eat properly. So we have to control these two components, the food that is going in, to control the muscle and the brain. So one key tip that I can give the support team, if you want to know a player's focus, look at blink rate. If a player is well hydrated, she will blink once every 3 seconds. If a player is blinking like this, either there's dust in the eyes, or the body's dehydrated, or there's a lack of focus, so they're trying aggressively to focus. So simple things, just your hydration coming in. What was the before going out to play? What was 1 hour before? Was it oatmeal or just was it sada pani and they jumped out of bed and went to play? So these are important things. Next slide. Okay, so I am going to give you performance for nutrition for performance, nutrition for recovery, and nutrition for shelf life. What's the meaning of shelf life?
Why?
When are you going to retire? Simple English. I'm sure most of you today have reached a stage in your career. You want that to be the furthest point right now. My job is to, how do you put this stuff into you to make sure that you command your brain and muscles every day to recover? So this is very, very important, okay? So imagine if you, I'll give you an example. Let's say when you went to play in any match, World Cup match or whatever it is, BCCI didn't take care of you. BCCI didn't arrange for the hotel. BCCI didn't arrange for water. BCCI didn't arrange for food and all of that stuff. What would be your energy levels? What would be your recovery levels? So the first thing that you need to understand is it's being arranged for you. Now that it's being arranged for you, I am asking you, who's putting the food into your mouth? Yourself. Remember I told you the example? She may have the gene to accept ghee, she may have the gene not to accept ghee. So the choices that we put in are based on scientific principles. Problem hai, hamara jo dal chawal roti hai, love and culture. Matlab dadi maa. Understand? So that is our very love and culture. No science. Like my mother says, oh, you should have this, you should have that. Every mother is a nutritionist. Correct, Tracy? Every mother is a nutritionist, top 10 nutritionists in the country. Okay? They know that how your performance will come and everything. So my point to you is, don't eat out of love and culture. Eat out of science. What works best for your body? What do you, how do you even today? Go forward. So this point already, yeah, just go back on. And we talked about the Fitbit. We talked about the Fitbit only. We talked about the Fitbit. It's giving you calorie estimation. Now, Apple. Can I have Apple? Thank you. How many calories in an apple? Ah. So you're eating apple. Everyone's eating apple. Why are you eating apple? Why are you not eating banana? Why are you not eating pomegranate? I'm not saying this is good or bad. I'm trying to make you understand. The moment you start putting things into your body, why are you doing it? Don't wait for Tracy or the support staff or BCCI to tell you, madam, you, this is how you should be eating. You choose your own path, right? You choose the pads, the fit and everything in terms of, okay, this strap is not necessary. You make the choice for the fit on your body. You make the choice on why an apple or why a banana.